let us see how we can actually set up Vagrant on this bare metal server, which we have provisioned from OVH. We have already set up CentOS on it. The steps that are involved in setting up Vagrant are, first we need to set up the underlying virtualization technology which we want to use to create virtual machines. It can be KVM with libvirt, or it can be VirtualBox. You have to have one of these things before we actually set up Vagrant. So there are a bunch of packages which you need to install, like KVM, libvirt, virt install, so on and so forth, bridutils. All these things will facilitate us not only to create virtual machines, but to enable networking between them. So I am logging into the server which we have provisioned and installed CentOS on top of it. Every time I am logging in by entering the password, I don't want to do it. I want to enable passwordless login. If you are using Mac or Linux, you can use this command called SSH copy ID. And then you can actually give your username and the hostname. Before using SSH copy ID, you need to make sure that you have public key and private key. If you haven't done before on your Mac or Linux machine, where you have created the public key and private key, just run ssh-keygen. It will create a public key and private key by names id_rsa and id_rsa.pub under directory called .ssh in your home directory. You just type ssh-keygen and hit enter twice or thrice whenever it prompts, and it will create those keys for you. To connect to a remote server without using password, we can copy our public key, which is generated with SSH keygen, onto the remote machine into authorized keys under .ssh of the user using which we are trying to connect. So in this case, I am trying to connect to training at rnd.itversity.com. For training user, there will be a directory called .ssh. In that .ssh, it will create authorized keys file if it doesn't exist, and then it will add our public key into it. Okay, so assuming that you already ran ssh-keygen and generated public key and private key, if you are using Linux or Mac based environment, you can use ssh-copy ID and then give the username at the public DNS which we have assigned to our bare metal server. And only once you have to enter this password. You need to have password login before you set up passwordless login in a typical environment. There are alternatives, but in a typical environment, first you need to get the password based login so that you can enable passwordless login. Okay. Now, as the public key is copied into authorized keys, I can actually run SSH and it will not prompt for password anymore. It can improve your productivity if you actually enable this passwordless login. You don't need to remember the password. You don't need to type every time. Once you are done with this, you can copy paste this sudo command where all the tools that are required to run Vagrant on top of it will be installed. It will take a bit of time because there are a bunch of packages which needs to be downloaded, installed, verified, and started. You can see here there are 27 packages that are already downloaded. Now it is installing those 27 packages. And after that, it will actually start something called libvirt daemon. We might have to restart after setting up few things. Okay. Let us go back to the documentation. Once this is done, you can now install Vagrant. If you directly install Vagrant, you might be able to install, but it will not be able to create virtual machines unless we have a virtualization technology such as KVM with the other packages. Even with VirtualBox, you have to install multiple tools on that machine so that we can leverage VirtualBox to create virtual machines as part of Vagrant. Okay. In this case, I want to use KVM, not VirtualBox. There are reasons for that. KVM actually can create virtual machines in parallel, whereas VirtualBox cannot. So Vagrant with KVM can actually create virtual machines in parallel. So here I am downloading, I need to use sudo. I am downloading and installing by providing the link of the RPM. Let us see if it is latest. So I'm going to vagrantup.com, and then if you click on download, as we are trying to download for CentOS 64 bit, you can click on this. You can right click and copy link address, and let us paste this to see what is the version we are trying to download and install now. Now it is 2.1.4 or 2.1.4. As per the instructions, it was 2.1.2. There won't be any significant differences between these versions. So let me download the latest one. So using m-y, if you can actually download the RPM through a web URL also. And in this case, I am downloading Vagrant and installing on this bare metal server after setting up CentOS 7 and all the virtualization tools that are required to create virtual machines. Okay, now you also have to group install development tools. It is required to have the development tools. Again, you have to install these things with sudo. There are 45 packages which it is downloading and installing. It will take a moment. Once the installation is done, the next thing you need to do is you need to restart the libvirtd, and you have to enable libvirtd to get started whenever we restart the machine. So systemctl is the command to manage the startup services. So if you disable any service, it will not be started automatically when the server is rebooted. If you enable, it will be started automatically when the server is rebooted. Okay, so once the installation is done, let us restart libvirtd. The installation is not done yet. Now the installation is done. Restarting libvirtd and enabling it so that it is always started whenever we reboot the machine. Once you do these things, next you have to update etcfs tab. Okay, if you don't update this, the KVM does not work. So you have to say sudo vi etc fs tab. This is with respect to CentOS 7. Already you can see there is one entry with respect to dev pts. Let's comment that out and then paste whatever is there as per the documentation, and let us format this so that it is a bit readable. Instead of using defaults, we are actually using something called GID equal to 5 and mode equal to 620. Okay. Now you can actually run mount-o and remount the dev pts. Again, you have to use sudo here, and then you have to install plugin called Vagrant libvirt. Only when have this plugin, it can interact with the KVM and other relevant services to create virtual machines. So you need to make sure that the Vagrant plugin, Vagrant libvirt, is installed after Vagrant is installed. By default, it works with VirtualBox, but in this case, we don't want to use VirtualBox, and hence we need to add this additional plugin. Now the plugin is installed. What you can do is you can create a directory here, mkdir, let's say CentOS 7 demo or CentOS 7 itself. Get into the directory and then run Vagrant init CentOS/7. It will actually create a Vagrant file, and you can actually look at the Vagrant file. It is nothing but a Ruby script. Most of the lines are commented out except two. One is this one, vagrant.configure of two, and then it is saying what is the VM box it should use, and this is nothing but a Ruby script. Once you do this, you can actually run sudo vagrant up and then you have to use a provider as libvirt, because we are not using the default one, which is nothing but VirtualBox. As we are using libvirt, we have to use this additional argument called provider equal to libvirt and hit enter. Now it will download the box with CentOS 7, and it will actually set up the virtual machine with CentOS 7 using that box. It will just take a moment to create this virtual machine, probably 2 to 3 minutes overall. Even if you want to create multiple virtual machines, we can actually improvise on the script which is generated when we actually say Vagrant in it, and we should be able to create multiple virtual machines in one shot. Now the virtual machine is almost created. Now you see the virtual machine is created, and you can actually say sudo vagrant ssh, and you should be able to connect to this virtual machine. Also, if you actually say vagrant and hit enter, it actually give us the list of vagrant commands. So you can actually bring up by saying up, you can suspend it, you can stop it by using halt. Init is the one which we have used to create the vagrant file, using which the VMs are set up. We can use ssh to connect to the machine which is already up and running. If it is suspended, if you want to resume, you can say resume and it will be resumed. Okay, so there are all these commands which will facilitate you to manage your virtual machines. If you want to get the status of your virtual machines, you can run status. Again, you have to use sudo here. And you can see that it is in running state, and the name of the virtual machine is default. We can change the name of the virtual machine. We can actually configure to run multiple virtual machines in one shot, to launch multiple virtual machines in one shot, etc. We will actually get into those details. As part of this section, we only see the high level steps where we provisioned the server from OVH, set up CentOS 7 on top of it, then we have installed Genome Desktop, then we have actually understood what Vagrant is, and after installing the necessary packages to create virtual machines using KVM, we have set up Vagrant, and we have validated that we are able to create the virtual machine using Vagrant with KVM.